Thank you very much. You were talking about human capital from an economic point of view, which is extremely important. Now we're going to have a person who talks about human capital also from a dignity point of view, which I also know that you are very aware of. In our first conference, 2011, about social entrepreneurship and philanthropy, one of the projects that we presented there is, was Diambars. And Diambars is a project that I have followed now for, I think, 7 years, 8 years. And I continue being very impressed and very proud of what Diambars has been doing. Proud because, in a way, I feel linked to it. Impressed because it's so good sports-wise, economically, and human, when it comes to human dignity. Diambars takes passion for sports into passion for life, helping young kids in so far Senegal and South Africa to find their talents, not only in sports, but using the passion they have for sports and the talent they have to see that there are other sides of life and helping them get education. And one of the heroes, there are many heroes in Diambars, but one of the founders, Jimmy Boucou, is one of my great heroes. And I want you to welcome Jimmy, who will tell you a little about what they are doing now and about Diambars in the future. Jimmy.
Thank you. Thank you, Ingrid. Hi. To begin, I would like to share with you a dream we had almost 12 years ago. Patrick Vieira, Bernard Lama, who is the former French goalkeeper and a friend of mine, Sayer Sek. So, Signor, when you
kufikisa maina, kufikisa maina. Kufikisa maina, kufikisa maina. Tapiru.
Thank you. So it was our dream 10 years ago, and now I will show you what we achieved, and then finish with our vision for the next 10 years. So our vision was to use the passion for football as a driving force for education, our objective to create champions in football and in life at the Diambars Institute that we want to build in many countries, to develop a social project based on the values of respect, tolerance, integrity, and nonviolence. It's very important for us, those values, and to contribute to the Millennium Development Goals and to the Education for All movement. Our mission is to make Diambars a flagship project in education and sport, to implement Diambars' pedagogical model as widely as possible, and to set up Diambars Institute around the world, not only in Africa, and to use the influence of football stars to promote the values of Diambars. What did we achieve in 10 years? That is the result. You can see we have five artificial pitches and the buildings for the kids, where they can go to school, where they can learn life. And so that's, we are very proud of what we achieved, because when we set up the, we launched the first stone, we invited the president of Senegal, and he told us that he would never come to a first stone, because most of the time in Africa, we don't launch the second stone. So he said that he would come for the opening day, which will be in November. Some results, sport results, I will do very quickly. We are now in first division in Senegal. We are top of the league. We finished second last year, only with players coming from the academy. The oldest are just 24 years old, and the youngest is 16. Our school results, 69 got the college exams. We are very proud of that. 31 got the baccalaureate. 3 got a license. And 1 got a master in finance. And now he's coming back to the academy. So it's a very good return for Diambars. Our financial results, we create a very good business model, where when some players sign in professional clubs in Europe, the clubs have to pay back to the academy the price that would have been if they had been formed here in their country. So in 4 years, we managed to raise 2.5 million euros. I want to add something about the clubs. I really want to thank the clubs here in Norway, because they are almost the only one who respect that rule that has been set up by FIFA to pay the what we call the how do you call that the price of the formation. The project expansion, our vision is to go to our leaders in Africa and explain how they can benefit economically, socially, and for the image of the country. We have this now this proof of concept. We are ready now to spread our project, our concept all over Africa and somewhere else, because we had in Brazil, we had a demand on this project to set up the same in Brazil. And last week I was in London with some friends who are in the basketball, and we decided that what we achieved was good enough to share and to do it with other clubs and other sports. And we're gonna work with basketball. And I met the vice president of NBA for Africa, and he's kind to do the same with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy. As you recognize probably that young, slim guy on the features there.
That's me.
Yeah, he was a winner. Jimmy, you should sit on the panel.